Constructors come and go, drivers rise and fall. But even as politics change and history moves on, the spirit of competition burns as strongly as it ever has. Welcome back then to Formula One, as battle is joined at the summit of motorsport once again. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today, though, ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. And great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today? And how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, the surface looks clean enough, but I'm a little bit worried about the track temperature. It's pretty cool out there, which could give some teams difficulty when it comes to keeping their tyres in the right operating window.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. An immense...
Clutch in. Hold until lights out. Feed in the throttle. Let's build the revs.
Making this worse.
this lap, you can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here. So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the
Hi, I'm Emma Jenkins. I'm a specialist in contract law, and I've been brought in to work as your agent. I'll be working to get you the best deal in the boardroom, which means you need to do the best possible job out there on the circuit. When you get new contract offers, either from new teams or an amendment to your existing offer, it'll come through me. I'll also keep you up to date on discussions behind the scenes to change your terms or any specific goals that the team has set for you. If a contract offer does come through, I'll present to you the available offers and then you can make the call. I assume that all sounds fine. Well then, good luck this season and I'll catch you later.
Welcome to Melbourne, where the practice session is about to start for this weekend's Australian Grand Prix. The pre-race talking is over. Now it's time for the drivers to show their worth.
In the unforgiving world of Formula One, free practice sessions are a vital part of any Grand Prix weekend. During your F1 career, you'll be able to utilise these sessions.
This is Jeff speaking. I've been assigned as your race engineer. There's a lot of hard work ahead of us, but the team believes in you. I just know you're going to be great. The car's good to go, so head out onto track whenever you like. Don't push the car just yet. Track is still green. Try and take it easy for the first couple of laps.
Yeah.
That's the fastest lap so far. Well done. Make sure to run some of our practice programs. They don't all need to be done in one session, but there's valuable data there to help race strategy and car development.
Thank you.
is badly damaged. You've lost a lot of downforce on the car. Pit, offering you a new front wing.
Quick look at the classification at the end of...
Hi. Good to meet you at last. My name's Chris, and I'll be working with you as your Chief of Vehicle Development. It'll be my job to get your feedback as a driver and to direct our upgrade design in the areas that you feel are most lacking. At each Grand Prix, we can run a series of practice programs and log the performance of the car as you drive it at its limit. This gives us data that we can utilize to develop various performance improvements. In order for me to know which upgrades to prioritize, I'll need you to select a development area that you'd like us to focus on. And you can do that in the R&D section of your laptop. Anyway, that's all for now. But I'll keep you up to date, okay? I'll see you soon.
tyres should remain dry. We will keep you informed of any changes to the weather.
Thank you.
okie dokie. We'd like to get a tyre wear program done on at least one compound during these sessions. We can get some good strategy and development information, so it's worth the effort. Sebastian is in P3. To spend time repairing the damage to the car. So far, our first little